Hello from Chem Help ASAP. This video is super exciting. It brings together a lot of ideas from preclinical drug research. In an earlier video, we covered the free drug hypothesis, an idea that the unbound concentration of the drug in the plasma is equal to the concentration of the drug at the target, assuming distribution is diffusion controlled. The free drug hypothesis actually lets us make dosing predictions. On the screen is a new equation that allows us to calculate a dose, a mass of drug. Cpunbound is the desired concentration at the target. CLint is intrinsic clearance. Tau is the dosing interval. That's a new one. And F is the bioavailability. Let's walk through these variables quickly. Cpunbound is the concentration that we feel is necessary for therapeutic activity. This is a therapeutic concentration. We've talked about intrinsic clearance. This is hepatic clearance as predicted through an in vitro assay. Something we didn't mention is that CLint varies based on F sub U. So the importance of the unbound fraction is a key concept for intrinsic clearance. Tau is a dosing interval. It's the time between doses. A larger interval means you'll need a larger dose. A larger dose to maintain CP during the time, the interval dose time. For F, if bioavailability is smaller, then you'll need a larger dose because less drug is reaching the plasma, the central compartment. This is all fine, but what is the desired concentration at the target? Well, we get that number from our potency assays. For an enzyme inhibitor, we might use an IC50 value. A very important concept is that we can start making dose predictions based on data from various in vitro assays. All these variables come from in vitro assays. This equation summarizes an idea called PK PD, predicting how to sustain in vivo efficacy, that's pharmacodynamics, there's our PD, from in vitro pharmacokinetic PK parameters. Quality dosing predictions are a vital step in the successful transition of a lead into animal trials and ultimately clinical trials in humans. Thank you for watching. I hope this video and the others on pharmacokinetics have given you a better sense of how PK shapes a drug discovery program. Please subscribe, like, or leave a comment. Take care.